Good morning. I greet you in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. And it's so good to see you and be with you again in this worship service. We're just about ready to start our service for the morning. And this is the day that the Lord has made, and we're going to rejoice and be glad in it. If you will, if you'll bow your head for just a moment of prayer. Eternal truth, how good it is to be able to call upon your holy and righteous name. We magnify you, we glorify you, we acknowledge that you are an awesome God. You're a good God, a great God, and one who can do anything but fail. We seek your presence right here with us at this hour. Come and touch these hearts of ours. Fill us with your Holy Spirit. Remind us that you are a God who hears and answers prayer, that you are the maker and creator of every good and perfect gift. Remind us that we can lean on you, we can depend on you, we can count on you to be there at a time that we need you most. We thank you, we bless you. In Jesus' name we pray, amen and amen. And now for our opening hymn for the morning, we lift our hands in the sanctuary.
We live.
There are two passages of scripture for your listening pleasure. This morning, one is recorded in the book of Isaiah, the 6th chapter, and verses 1 through 8. And then the gospel according to St. Mark, the 3rd chapter, and verses 7 through 10. Listen for the word of the Lord to speak unto you in the book of Isaiah, the 6th chapter, and verses 1 through 8. In the year that King Uzziah died, I saw the Lord. He was sitting on a throne high and lifted up, and his train filled the temple. Around him, flaming creatures were standing, each which had six wings. And each creature covered its face with two wings, and its body with two, and used the other two for flying. And they were calling out to each other, "Holy, holy, holy, Lord Almighty is holy. His glory fills the world." And the sound of their voices made the foundation of the temple shake, and the temple itself became filled with smoke. And I said, "There's no hope for me, for I'm doomed, because every word that passes my lips is sinful, and I live among a people whose every word is sinful. And yet my own eyes have seen the King, the Lord of hosts." Then one of the creatures flew down to me, carrying a burning coal that he had taken from the altar with a pair of thongs. And he touched my lips with the burning coal and said, "Lo, this has touched thy lips, and now thy guilt is gone. Your sins are forgiven." And then I heard the Lord say, "Whom shall I send, and who will go for us?" And I answered, "Here am I, send me." This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be unto God. And again, the whole church said, Amen. And now as we turn now to the gospel according to St. Mark, the 3rd chapter, in a few verses, 7 through 10, and this is the text from which we shall attempt to preach from this morning. Again, listen for the word of the Lord to speak unto you. Jesus and his disciples went away to Lake Galilee, and a large crowd followed him. And when they had come from Galilee, from Judea, from Jerusalem, from the territory of Idumea, and from the territories on the east side of the Jordan, and from the region around the cities of Tyre and Sidon, all of these people came to Jesus because they had heard of the things that he was doing. The crowd was so large that Jesus told his disciples to get a boat ready for him so that the people would not crush him. And he had healed many people, and all of the sick kept pushing their way toward him in order to touch him. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be unto God. And again, the whole church said, Amen. Amen. And now, by way of announcements, we want to certainly say happy birthday to all of those who are experiencing a happy birthday during this month of October. May you witness and see many more. We also are grateful to Brother Newsom and Sister Mary for what they do behind the scenes in terms of the welfare that they have for our church. And what they do to keep our church going. We're grateful to them, and as well as the great people at Mount Vernon who work so tirelessly to make sure that Mount Vernon is well. And so we're grateful to Brother Ralph Foster, Sister Sharon Stone, Yoslyn Griffin, and for many others who play an integral part in the upkeep and the welfare of the church. Amen. By way of prayer now, we firmly believe that our God is a God who hears and answers prayer, and we are living witnesses that God is continuing to work miracles, not only in our lives, but in the lives of people around the world. We stand in need of a miracle today in our country and countries around the world. We pray that God will continue to heal those bodies, particularly those who are suffering from the COVID-19. I know that each of you are keeping up with what is going on and listening to the news, listening to the scientists and to the local and federal officials. Thus far, as of today, 217,000 have died because of the COVID-19. 8 million are affected by it. And so we are in prayer for one another and for our nation and for people around the world. We pray for a vaccine. We pray that our people may be healed. And with that, we lift up those who are sick in prayer, those who are in convalescent homes, and even those who are in prison. We pray that God will speak to each heart in the manner in which it stands in need. And then as we pray, we want you to remember your own concerns and lay them at the feet of Jesus. And as we pray, I want you to be reassured that God will, some way, somehow, answer your prayers. And when he answers, you will be glad. Let us go to God in prayer. How grateful we are for this moment to be able to come to you with bowed heads and with humble hearts, knowing that you are our God, one who loves us, one who understands us, one who forgives and heals us. We thank you for what you have done in the past. You have made ways out of no ways. You have lifted us out of the muck and miry clay. You have turned our darkness into light and our sorrows into joys. And for that, Father, we say thank you. We thank you for the love that binds us together, that love that reaches from heart to heart and breast to breast, that love that helps us to know that we are to love one another as you have so loved us. Greater love is no man than to lay down his life for a friend. We thank you that you loved us so much that you gave your only begotten Son to die on the cross of Calvary for the sins of the whole world. If we had 10,000 tongues, we couldn't thank you enough. We couldn't praise you enough. We couldn't lift you too high for men to see, because you have been so good to us. And for that, Father, we say thank you. Now, Lord, we pray your blessings upon all of those persons who are sick, not only on our prayer list, but in our communities and around the world. We pray for healing. We pray for your word of comfort to go out, that others may know that you love and that you care for us. Speak now. Speak tenderly that we may hear your voice, that we may come to the understanding that in the depths of our troubles, you're always there. In the midst of our storms, you will navigate us through. In our circumstances, in our situations, in whatever condition we find ourselves in, help us to be content. Content in knowing that you are a God who's able to do exceedingly above more than any of us could ever do. Give us peace now. Give us hope. Give us joy. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. And now for our hymn of preparation, Encourage Yourself. church say amen? Let us say amen again. There is a word from the Lord. Jesus and his disciples went to Lake Galilee, and a large crowd followed them. They were from Galilee, from Judea, from Jerusalem, and from the territories of Idumea and the territory on the east side of the Jordan, and from the surrounding regions of the cities of Tyre and Sidon. All of these people came to Jesus because they heard of the good things he was doing. The crowd was so large that Jesus said to his disciples, "Get a boat ready for me so that the people would not crush him." He healed many people. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be unto God. And again, the whole church said, amen. The subject that we shall endeavor to use this morning, with God's help and with your prayers. They came to him because of what they heard. They came to him because of what they heard. As it is our custom, we invite you to look at your neighbor. Hopefully your neighbor is there or your loved one. Amen. Let's say it together. Come on. They came to him because of what they heard. One more time. Come on. They came to him because of what they heard. How many times have you heard about the good things that someone else has done? When you hear about good things that others are doing, you either believe it or not. If you believe the good things that you have heard, then you'll go by and see the person who's doing it. I remember some years ago, I was in search of a good mechanic. My old car wasn't running right. It was smoking and hiccuping and doing a whole lot of different things it wasn't supposed to do. And so I happened to be talking to a friend. So I told him that, you know, what my car was doing, and I was new in town, and I needed a mechanic. I wish I knew a mechanic. He said, "Oh, I know one." I said, "Really?" He said, "Yeah." I say, "I know one. He's well qualified. He's a certified mechanic. He used to work at one of the large dealerships, a name I won't call. And he knows about motors. He knows about tune-ups, transmissions. He can do it all." Say, "So he's worked on my car," and named a few other people that he worked on cars, and say, "I highly recommend him. And as a matter of fact, he's honest. And you tell him what's wrong with your car, he'll look at it, and before he charge you or anything, he'll tell you what's wrong and tell you what the bill is going to be." Well, when they told me that, I believed what I heard. And because I believed what they told me, I took my car and we went to see him. And he fixed my car. And so what you hear sometimes can pay off, particularly if it's true. I'll tell you another instance. It was many years ago. A friend of mine come running to me, said, "Darryl," said, "Darryl, I saw your name in the paper. And that kind of frightened me. And I, you know, Because, you know, they had the Forward Times and had the Black Page and had several others. No, I hadn't done anything wrong. He said, I saw your name on the state controller's list. He said, you know, that's a list where they put people's name if they got money that's been left over somewhere. I said, what? He said, yeah. He said, man, your name is on there. And church, I believed what I heard. And because I believed what I heard, I got in the car and I drove all the way down to Austin to get to the state controller, amen. And when I got there, they said, yeah, you got $50, amen. And so wasn't that much, but it was true what I heard. I believed it and it paid off. Faith comes through hearing, and hearing by the word of God. If you hear it, you believe it, go see about it. And so here, the crowd heard about the good things that Jesus was doing, and they came to see him. Now, I'm excited that, number one, they came to see Jesus. And that's a blessing within itself when you come. Amen. In regardless of the reason that you come, amen, we understand and the reason that they came, the crowd, because they heard about Jesus. But there are many other reasons why people come to Jesus. But in spite of or regardless of the reason that you come, any reason to come to Jesus is a mighty good reason. Amen. Because when you come to him, I'm about to get happy here. I said, when you come to him, amen, and humble yourself. When you come to him, amen, you always receive more than what you came for. Amen. If you came for salvation, he has that in the storehouse. Amen. If you come for love, it's there. If you come for peace, it's there. If you come for deliverance, it's there. If you come for healing, it's there. Come to Jesus while you have time. He will make your life brand new. And he will see you through. The news about Jesus and his healing powers had spread throughout the town of Galilee. It was all in Judea. It was in Jerusalem. It was in the surrounding regions of Tyre and Sidon. It was by the Jordan. Amen. And people came because they had heard about the things that he was doing. Note here, many people reacted differently to the healing powers and the teachings of Jesus. The Pharisees, when they heard about the good things that Jesus was doing, they were jealous. They were terrified. They thought he was going to take over the government. And so they plotted to kill him. When his own family, Jesus' own family, heard about the miracles that he was performing and about the healings, they went in the synagogues to get him out because they thought he had lost his mind, and they didn't want anybody thinking that one of the family members had gone off of that rock. And so they tried to get him out. You remember when they came in and sent a man in to the synagogues and told Jesus, said, your mother and your family, they're outside and they want you. But Jesus told them, no, said, you are my mother, you are my father, you are my family. Anyone who obeys the word of God, that's who my mother is. And so here, they came because of what they had heard. And so Jesus had to leave the safety of the sanctuary. He had to leave the safety of the temple. He had to leave the safety of the synagogue and go to the place out in the open called the Lake of Galilee. You see, in the temple, in the synagogue, could nobody bother Jesus, amen, because there were protocol in there. But Jesus, the crowd was so large, Jesus had to go to the Lake of Galilee out in the open. And they went there, wanted to get away from the crowd. You know, every now and then you need to get away from the crowd. They went there for a quiet time together. They went there to meditate and to pray. And every now and then, I believe it's good to just get away from the hustle and bustle of life and get yourself where you can just pray and talk with God. One songwriter said, just a little talk with Jesus will make everything all right. And then, see, you can take everything to the Lord in prayer. Oh, what needless pains we bear, all because we do not carry everything to the Lord in prayer. They went there so that Jesus could get them ready for what was going to happen to him in Jerusalem at the cross of Calvary. Jesus knew that he was going to die, and so he wanted a quiet place where he could get his disciples ready, tell them that I'm going to be delivered into the hands of men. They're going to scourge me. They're going to crucify me, but don't worry about it. The third day, I'll rise again. They went for a quiet time, but the crowd kept pressing in. The sick, the afflicted. They kept coming to Jesus. And look here. When they came to Jesus, they came with expectations. Notice here, the Bible says, as we look at the text, they came to Jesus. I want you to mark that down in your Bible, in your notes. Put this down. They came to Jesus. Who were the they? The crowd. Who were the crowd? They were the ones who were sick. They were the ones who were in need of healing. They were the ones who needed salvation. They were the ones who needed deliverance. The crowd came to Jesus. As I said earlier, anytime you come to him, amen, it doesn't matter what the reason is, it's always good, amen. They came to Jesus, amen. Now, they could have gone to the soothsayers, they could have gone to the fortune tellers, amen, but they came to Jesus, amen, amen. And you know, it's good to know, I'm about to preach now, ain't nobody in here, I ain't looking at nothing but the cop. But it's good to know who to come to and who to call on in a time of need. The Bible says that they came to Jesus. Amen, amen, amen. They came to Jesus. And church, when you come to Jesus, your wants will be fulfilled. I remember the man who was possessed with demons. And I remember how he came to Jesus. Came to Jesus because no one else would listen to him. Ostracized from society, kicked out of the house, a crazy man, lived among the tombs, beat his breath, put tar and feather on him. No one could do anything with him. But oh, when he met Jesus, even in his craziness, he recognized who Jesus was, fell at his feet and said, Lord, make me clean again. And Jesus made him clean, healed his body, restored him to his right mind. Why? Because he came to Jesus. I tell you, there's a blessing in coming to the Lord. Secondly, They came to Jesus because of what they heard. Because of what they heard. What have you heard about Jesus that would make you come to him? Amen. I heard some things about him. Have you heard? Amen. Mama told me, grandmama told me that he's a friend that stick closer than a brother. They told me that if you ever need him, that you could call on him. They tell me that he's a prayer answering God. They told me that he was a healer. They told me that he was a deliverer. They told me that he was a strong tower, that he can turn dark yesterdays into bright tomorrows. They told me about him. What have you heard about Jesus? In my mind's eye, I believe that these followers who followed Jesus, no doubt that they had heard some good things about Jesus. No doubt they heard that he healed the sick. He raised the dead, gave sight to the blind, made lame leg walk again, and death ears say, I heard it to the grave. They heard something about Jesus. And every person who heard something about Jesus and went to him, they received more than what they deserved. You remember the woman in Capernaum who had suffered 12 long years. Issue of blood trying to find a cure. She had spent all of her money on doctors and soothsayers. She ran out of money. And yet she was not cured. But somebody, one of the neighbors, told her about a man called Jesus. And I don't know really what they said, but no doubt they said, he can heal you. He can make you well again. And because she heard that, the Bible says she believed. And the reason we know she believed and had faith in what she heard is because on the way, she said, if I could only touch the hem of his garment, I know I'll be made whole again. And when she got there and touched Jesus' garment, she was made whole again. Oh, if you go to him, based on what you heard, you'll be filled. The shepherd boys, they heard about him. The three wise men, they heard about him. And when they went to see him, when they left and went a different way, their hearts were filled with joy. And they were able to tell the world, mine eyes have seen the King, the Lord of hosts. Not only did they come because of what they heard, but no doubt there were some who came because of what they saw. In other words, you can come as an eyewitness. Amen. Amen. Some came to Jesus because they saw him walk on the water. They saw him take two fish and five loaves of bread and feed a multitude of 5,000. Some came to him because they saw him turn water into wine. Some came to him because they saw how he suffered on Calvary's cross when they speared him in the side and put a crown of thorns on his head and put nails in his hands and in his feet. Some came to him because they saw him, how he suffered, how he died because of my sins and your sins and the sins of the whole world. They came to him. And then there was some who came because of what they knew. Amen. Saul came to him because Saul knew that the Lord was a Savior. Because on the road of Damascus, the Lord had picked him up and turned his life around again. How many know that Jesus is a mighty good Savior? And then the children of Israel, they came because they knew that he was a mighty good deliverer. Because he delivered them from the land of Egypt, delivered them out of the desert when they were hungry and thirsty. They cried to the Lord and he rained manna from heaven and brought water from a flint rock. If you come to him based on what you know, you will leave there able to go through anything based on the things that you know about Jesus. whatever reason you have to come to Jesus, it's a mighty good reason. If you're broken, you can come to him. He'll put you back together again. Yes, he's in the junkyard business. He knows how to put back broken pieces. He healeth the broken heart and bindeth up their wound. And then if you're empty on the inside, you know, sometimes life can make us feel empty. When we lose things, when we lose loved ones that we cherish, it makes us feel empty on the inside. But I tell you, if you come to Jesus, he can fill the void. I tell you, he can give you joy in the midst of sadness. He can give you peace in your troubled times. Hope for a better tomorrow. And yes, yes, if you just need the Lord, you ought to come to him. Well, as I close, I came to Jesus one day. And I didn't come to him because of what I'd heard. I didn't come to him because of what I knew. I didn't come to him because of what I had seen. I didn't come to him because of what I had experienced. I came to him just as I was. I was weary, wounded, and sad. But I found in him a resting place, and he has made me glad. And I stopped by to tell somebody, because I came to Jesus, I'm glad right now. I'm glad that I came to Jesus. And you will be too if you come to him, regardless of what you've heard, what you've seen, what you've experienced, and what you know. Any reason to come to Christ is a mighty good reason. Let us pray. Gracious God, I give you thanks right now. I thank you for all of those who have come to you, who are coming to you right now, who are giving you their heart, who are opening up and say, Lord, come into my life. I'm a sinner. Make me whole again. Father, we come to you. We lift our hands to you. No other help we know. And if thou wouldst draw thyself from thee, whither shall we go? Thank you, Lord. We bless you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Now for our benediction. Now to the only wise God, who's able to keep us from falling, his majesty and dominion be with us now and forth and forevermore. Let us now go forth and tell all the world they came to him because of what they heard. In Jesus' name, amen and amen.
Church.